Today, here we are going to discuss or execute practical number third, that is called as a validating the waveform control using the DHTML concept of internet programming subject. Now, what is the aim of today's practical? To create client-side script for validating the waveform control using the DHTML. Here you observe what I want. The information technology, name, passwords, some text we want to write, register and reset. These are the most important field here we require to validate that page using the DHTML concept. Here you observe this page says password must be at least 6 characters. That means this is validating your form. If you click OK, so you will continue by entering the proper informations. Okay, so that concept is called as validating of your form or of your page. That is very important related to that. The aim is to create client-side script for validating the waveform control using the DHTML concept. Now, we are going to discuss or execute the code by clicking this execution concept. We open that file where we observe the output. As we consider, it shows the welcome to GIP City informations technology department, where have the text field that is called as a name, second password, some text field here we must enter, register and reset. These are the different button. If we write the name Abhay, ABHAY, Abhay. If we write the password ABHAY, we write some text TGPCT, then we register it. Then it shows the output, you are valid users. Thank for register your site. Okay. Now, what here we are going to observe? Abhay, abhay.it. Password 1, 2, 3, and we are going to register. The password must be at least 6 character long. That means we are not providing the password as per the specifications. What are the specifications provided here? Okay, so you may okay it and continue it. Again, you may observe that if we make it as a blank, then we observe what is out. So name can't be blank. So this is a way where we can validate our page by using client side validation. So this is called as a validating of page, given page. Now we are going to observe the code, how we validate that code. View source code. HTML script function validate form. What here we provide functions validate form, opening brace, variable name equals to document.write, my form dot name equals to value, variable password equals to document.my form dot password equals to value. Here we provide our conditions. What are the validating conditions here we require? If name equals to null or name equals to blank, then what message I want to print? Alert message I want to print, name can't be blank. Okay, return false. Else, if the password is less than 6 character, then what I want? Alert message, password must be at least 6 character long. So these are the message where we return under the script section. Now we are going to discuss how we design that body part. Here you may observe what are the designing part you are observing on the that body sections. It must be written under the body sections, okay, and it must be validated using the script tag. That is called as client side script tag. Here you may observe where we use the field set. Field set used to give a field set and listen is used to give the box to your content. What are the content here you have? What are the contents you have? Information technology department, name, okay, password, text area, input type, okay, and submit button. So these are the different types of field here we have created. So this can be possible using the input type equals to submit. If you want to create a submit button, how we create a submit buttons? Input type submit value registers. What value we have provided there? Sub registers. Here you may observe that register value. If you click here any, then we can reset it. Okay, so reset button is also working. Now here again you observe the NBPS. NBPS is used to give the spacing in your name and input text. Okay, password, input type password, name password, text area, what text columns here we have 20, write text area here, and text area break kar diya humne. So this is related to DHTML concept to create the or to validate the page. Okay, so this is regarding the how to validate our page. It shows to create client side script for validating or validate the web form control using the DHTML. You may observe here one output screen where we have the password must be at 6 characters long that already we have executed. So thank you.